Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I make a lot of videos about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about how to get to the code editor or to get to the developer console, as it's called within Salesforce. It's a little bit hidden, but I'm happy to show you. So the developer console is one way to edit code. There's other ways to edit code. You can do it through a variety of different code editing tools, but this is just the basic out of the box Salesforce code editor tool that you'll likely be using if you are going through Trailhead or you're just starting out on your developer journey. So I'm currently on the homepage. This is accessed anywhere. You're going to go to this cog like you would for setup, service setup, or editing page, or going to an object if you are within an object. And here you can go into the developer console. And it has created a space for you. From here, there are different things that you can do. You can open up a file. You can create a new whatever you want to create. You have a bunch of different options, classes, triggers, lightning, components, events, interfaces, tokens, visual forces, all these different things. You can also open, if you are coming back to a resource, you can open resources, open lightning resources. You can save, close, delete, download different logs. That's under file. You can edit. You can debug. You can test here. You can choose a workspace, and any helps or shortcut keys that might be helpful to you are there. At the bottom of your screen are the different logs, and this will tell you if there are currently any errors, like if you forgot a semicolon or if you forgot a parentheses to end something. You can run tests, checkpoints, queries, view the state, progress, and problems. Problems is probably where you're going to find any syntax errors. Now, one thing about this is that you are able to have different tabs open. So if you wanted to create a new class, I'm going to have this be class 1. It's not a legal name. Okay, let's try Snickerdoodle. Everyone loves Snickerdoodles. All right, so we now have a public class Snickerdoodle. If we wanted to, we could open up a new trigger. His name is Golden Dog. I'm just making this up, and it's going to be on the account. There we go. We would be able to go between the different tabs that we were working on. So that is kind of a basic overview of the developer console, how to get there. Yeah, I am dabbling in more developer content, so if you would like more of that, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, and thanks for stopping by. Subscribe if you're feeling generous, and check out my courses down below. I will catch you in the next one.